Hockey is a game of order. There is a set time to gather, to remain calm, to browse. There's a set time to stand quietly and listen. A time to join in. Everything about this is a model of predictability and excitement. A game played on 13 degrees of water. When the puck drops, goal scorers storm in and scorch the twine with dazzling plays. Okay, well, maybe that wasn't a twine scorcher, but here's one. Remember, they move right in and scorch the twine with dazzling plays. Everything about this game, played on 13 degrees of water, is predictable, including the goal stanchioned solidly into the arena floor. And whenever there's a question about a play, a man in black, white, and orange rules without argument. Players have tremendous abilities to control the puck, their stick handling skills resulting in thrilling scores. Stick handling skills. Goalies with their lightning-like reflexes and gloves can stop most shots from anywhere on the ice. Most shots. Ah, the sweetness of success. At long last, there can be a time for celebration and victory. In Denver equals a 10-gallon hat trick. But what kind of celebration would take place far away from wild, untamed Denver in very proper, very eastern Massachusetts when a player scored three goals? The goaltenders with their acrobatic moves can shut down even the most reputable of scoring machines. One other team in the arena besides the two on the ice. They baggage busted benches, and when the time comes to replace a defective net, they always have plenty more in stock. Like a hockey team on the ice, however, they have to be able to react to changes in decision. Like any team, on any field, anywhere, they are quick to cover for the mistakes of their mates. They don't pull many boners, but when they do, they remain as a hallmark. Here you see a buffalo facing west on a shirt, and a buffalo facing east on the ice. And sesquicentennial is just too hard to spell anyway. Hockey is more than shooting and skating. There are occasional soft but subtle interruptions. Striped shirt on the ice, or the guilty one in the box. You never know what will happen when the puck drops. Need verification? Ask those who have to keep calm in this predictable pastime on a pond. This is Mike Emrick.